Sound speed, camera speed. Miss Mitsumi, intro, take one.
Hey everybody, I'm Derek Mazzoni. This is Sama, Sales Circuit Music and Art. Our first on-location shoot, we are at WOMEX in Porto, Portugal. We have some fabulous artists tonight, starting with Aragaki Mutsumi from Okinawa. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I'm so happy to be here, so honored to be here.
Awesome.
Thank you very much.
Let's start with some music, please.
Mm-hmm. So, well, I'm going to sing you some from the classical music, some from folk music, and originals, my originals too. So the first song I'm going to sing you is from the folk music, Uranami Bushi. The title, I mean, the meaning of the song is like, this is a teaching song, encouraging song, that even if we sometimes bump into in our life the big waves or strong waves, but if we have faith, we can overcome anything. This is the meaning of the song.
That sounds like a perfect song for the times
for
that
the
we've
song.
Been through.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Aragaki Mutsumi.
Hi.
Well, how did you start in music? Why music?
This Okinawa music.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, my parents are from Okinawa, but actually I was brought up in Nagoya, that is mainland of Japan.
Okay.
And when I was about maybe 18 or some. 18, 17, 60, I don't know, was thinking about my identity at that time, when I was a high school, I think.
Okay.
So trying to find my identity, I was looking for something Okinawa. And then I met Okinawa music. Well, after that, I went to college, and then I started to do this music.
Was there a particular teacher? Was there a particular, like...
Yes, in Osaka.
Can you was it... Because a lot of people start playing mm-hmm. and then put it away.
Yeah.
What was it that made you decide that it was going to be the thing? Like, well, how did it resonate with you?
Well, actually, after maybe 5 or 10 years, I was about to stop it because... Oh. But... kind of boring, I thought. But I mean, before I started this music, I really loved African music, actually.
Okay.
And I'm looking for many archives of Okinawa music, gramophone or something. And I found something really, you know, passionate, kind of groovy thing in the past day, 100 years ago.
Okay.
And then it opened up my mind. And then I restart my... trying to learning and yeah.
Okay, that looks like a very complicated instrument to play. I'm familiar with it, but can you tell us a little bit about what does that instrument mean to Okinawan society, to Okinawan culture?
Well, this is it has long history. Mm-hmm. First of all, I think it's more than 600 or.
Okay.
I think it's Okinawan pop music or folk music is really popular and people know it. But there are some more diversity, like classical music. It's very interesting to see that many people are going to school and learning classical music or folk music or from a specific teacher. And then... It has a long line of teacher, student.
Okay, perfect, yeah. Perfect. So there's a scene in Okinawa? You feel like you're part of a bunch of different musicians? There's support for this?
I think so, yeah. Okay. For example, music from Okinawa, or do you know that? Or they're really supporting us to show this music to the world. For example, in WOMEX,
okay.
Of course. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Can we hear another song, please?
Okay. So this is from the classical music, mm-hmm. which is more like a spiritual one. So the lyrics is like this. The joy of life. How can I describe the joy of today? It's like a bud has just bloomed by catching a dew. So the joy of life, for me, the highlight of my life was the moment I gave birth to my child, actually, my daughter. So how about you?
And I know that feeling.
Yeah, so this is a Kajadifu Bushi from classical music from Okinawa, Utuduki Sabira.
Thank you.
party.
Beautiful work. Aragaki Mutsumi. When did you start playing with effects and incorporating that into your repertoire?
2 or 3 years, I think.
Okay. Was it just a quick evolution? Did you go to a concert and see this? Oh, I want to add that to that. Or was it something that you've been thinking about for a while? Because it adds a lot of texture,
yeah.
Especially with that song where you're... You know, when you're talking about, you mm-hmm. know, the joy of life,
yeah.
That puts you there. So I'm just curious how you went from there, because it's not overwhelming. It's not like suddenly that's all you're hearing, because the instrument is still very much growing from that. So how did that come about?
Well, I used to be just a student of a learner of this instrumental music.
Mm-hmm.
And many times and times trying to practice, right?
Yeah.
So in between the sounds, I had already hearing the sound in the space.
Okay.
So actually, I tried to do that, realize that with the musicians. But, you know, it's they didn't know what I'm playing here.
Okay.
So. And I didn't know how to explain that, so I started to make some demos with PC, and then I started to do this by myself with this all the equipment.
Okay, and it's working.
Yes, I think
so. You like it? I love the record, by the way. Thank you for making it. I know that you're also improvising and you're working with other musicians.
Yes.
How does that come about? Is it pretty easy, just come in and jam, or is it more structured?
I think it's not like that structured. It's something like my priority when I play with musician is like it's something like the rhythm of the breath or something between the notes or, you know, something nuance. We can feel each other the moment we play each other, the vibes, you know. So I don't want to make it a little bit, not like too much structured.
Okay.
So now I'm playing with the band of musicians who are very good at improvising. And
okay. Let's hear another song. I have a question, but I'll go into it later.
Kay.
Let's hear another song.
Thank you.
What are some of the lyrics in that song? Yeah.
As I told you, life is too short to, you know, too much trapped in a swamp. So you have to take care of yourself, or try to be yourself, or kind of thing.
Okay, perfect. Your songs are so timely for what we're in. So what has the last year and a half been like for you, being a musician, not being able to play? What's that been like?
I mean, actually, I'm a teacher of Sanshin and vocal. So usually I'm a teacher, actually. So and when I get chance, I perform in a live show or events. So well, in Okinawa, situation's really, really bad. So many lives are, events are canceled, and still now, we don't know where to go, actually. So I did this year, just two or three lives in Okinawa.
Okay, but are you teaching online, streaming? You have students?
Yes, online now.
Online. Mm-hmm. Are they just in Okinawa, or are they all over the world?
They're of course, Okinawa, and mainland, or Europe, or America.
Great. Yeah, great.
Yes.
This is what I wanted to ask you about a while ago. So most people don't know much about Okinawa.
Yes.
They just think it's Japan.
Mm-hmm.
And Okinawa has a very complicated history.
Yes.
It was just returned to Japan in like 1972, and it has a very large military base there, which has certain problems. Mm-hmm. There's jets flying all the time. There's environmental degradation.
Mm-hmm.
As an Okinawan musician, especially playing this instrument, you're presenting your culture and your people all over the world. And I'm curious if you could speak to that a little bit, like something that we don't know about Okinawa, or you're creating this beautiful music with this and adding layers to it that are really interesting. So it tells me that the music and Okinawa is evolving. There's something going on there. If you could speak to that, that would be beautiful.
In my perspective, I think watching my friend musicians, some musicians are intensively doing something resistance kind of song with the lyrics, you know, with Okinawan language.
Yeah.
So it depends on musicians. And as for me, actually, I didn't want to do that kind of thing at the beginning. But in the process of making CD, I was thinking, the first thing I wanted to do was that I wanted to be honest to what I'm hearing in my mind or in my, you know, in my head. And, you know, in reality, we usually, I mean often, the, you know, aircrafts are very near. The sound is really scary. So if I didn't put that sound in the CD, I was lying to, it was like it's a lie, you know.
Okay.
So maybe that's how I present Okinawa conflict or something.
Okay, that's beautiful.
Thank you.
Because I've been listening to the CD and I was trying to figure out where that haunting sound came from. At first I thought it was that the ocean, because it's an island, there's water around it, but there was something, another layer to it. Mm-hmm. So thank you for letting me know. That's beautiful. Can we hear some more music, please?
So the next song is from a folk song, Naku ni Hantabaru. The theme of the song is like the passion of love.
Ah,
That's freaking awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
You have some serious skill. So, a quick question. That instrument, when you... I've had other Okinawan artists on, and there's always like a bunch of them. How many do you own? You forgot?
Five or six, maybe.
Okay. Okay. Is it a specific... Do you have a relationship with the person who made it, or is it more you just go to the store and pick one up?
Actually, I was an artisan.
You made it too?
I was made. This is my teacher's.
Okay. And is it... Can you talk a little bit about it? Because one of the things I'm curious is that that seems to be an instrument that is in, love songs and also in spiritual music and sacred music. Do you know much about the history of the instrument? And can you speak to what role does it play in Okinawan culture right now?
I mean, nowadays, many people can buy Sanshin or... It's like more like commodity,
okay.
You know. But in those days, about maybe 100 years ago, more than that, there used to be a Ryukyu kingdom, right?
Okay.
So in those days, Sanshin is something more like, many people cannot touch.
Oh.
Something okay. like that. So only... The people who is in the court can have or play.
Okay.
So after maybe World War One or World War Two, things are more to ordinary people.
Okay.
So we can buy or touch or play very easily every day.
Okay.
So things are really changed.
Okay, that's good to know. Thank you. Can we have one more song?
Okay. So this is also from classical music, Chijuya Bushi. In this time of COVID, many restrictions, so we cannot freely cross the borders or oceans, right? So this is, if you have someone who is far away from you, but miss each other so much. So this is a song for you. Even if we are far apart, we don't have to worry because we share the same moon. Chijuya Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
I look forward to welcoming you to Seattle and spending some time.
I would love to.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks one and all. This is awesome. Cheers.
Thank you.